say that Putin was hiring out subversion against his own system, then you would have to claim something along the lines of his collaboration with the war in Ukraine as a proxy war against Russia by supporting the West insurgents to overthrow the Western countries in order to engage in the insurrection, threatening Russia, compelling his reaction to the activity of the proxy war in order to neutralize the threat of the prospect of future invasion, at which point setting up the destruction of his own country would have to be a thing that you would have to express from that point of view, at which point, if you want to continue the line of thinking, then you have to assume by its very nature that he is plotted against his own country and himself, which has the functional disvaluing of his own historical positions, at which point he would be acting outside of a natural state. Assuming that that would be the agreement, then you would have to engage in some kind of explanation of a Manchurian candidate, of him receiving some kind of subversions of drugging, nerve hacking, or other subversions to his own interests, which would explain his opposition to the larger war on David being published in its proper context, certifying his ability to use their crimes against David in the function as a legal character in the explanation on why the proxy war prompted threats secretly by his national security mechanism, which he would be retaliating against, would be fundamentally based on the subversion of David's mechanisms, and the function of the character David Bowles being subverted prevents the possibility of his original contracts with all countries, including the Russians, qualifying the original peace, qualifying the mechanism of their original wealth and stability, unless, of course, the mechanism is generated to remove David, then you can't have all of the benefits of having David. If he isn't there, then obviously all of his work doesn't effectively happen, at which point you can blame them and defame them and engage in every form of racism and bigotry against them, qualifying the mechanisms of threat against their secret surveillance mechanisms for their national security, which would legitimately have things which they would not publish in order to engage in the functionality of protecting national secrets, such as the counter-espionage functions of finding and subverting threats, generates the obligation of understanding that if Putin doesn't actually agree with the functionality of insurrection against his country, then he has to promote David Bowles under the original contracts, certifying the original treaties, qualifying the original peace, subverting all mechanisms of the threats that his national security are reacting to. At which point you have the active position where you need the function of world peace, which everyone claims to be working for. Now, if Russia doesn't do that, it is operating in its own interest but subverting the larger goal, which it claims is the agenda through the subversion of the proxy war, which is primarily promoted through the war on David, subverting the security mechanisms from the original estimate, qualifying the national security mechanisms, certifying his ability to the prosperity, at which point the West proxy war against Russia qualifies the subversions through the sanctions and many other mechanisms, which are a collapse of the West mechanism, at which point the collapse of the West collapses into the insurrections, at which point the Russians would have opposition with the more primal Nazi opposition, which have actively been infiltrating the mechanisms of the Western governments, at which point you would have a Skynet kind of arrangement where you have in the Terminator series the function of shooting a fly pesky little virus thing with a rocket launcher, and the rocket launcher was Skynet and the fly was Skynet, at which point you have the exponential compounding of the real threat, qualifying their actual state of danger, exponentially falling into a greater trap. By removing the checks and the balance systems through the collapse, he creates a greater threat, which would be the promotion of the subversion of him planning his own destruction and the dismantlement of his country, which is the counter argument to the claim that he doesn't have the equivalent policy in mind, at which point the assumption is that the racism of the West is the greater war on David, at which point the racism is against David Bull's race, which they projected he would have started as the founder or patriarch or Semitic function of the new first world country, which would have been created exclusively from his wealth and connections, qualifying the treaties and the original world peace, qualifying all of these mechanisms of the censoring, abuse, and extermination of David's race is that new country and its society and culture and all of its due diligence, which destabilizes everyone. Now, the activity of the genocide generates the entire mess against the international community, and the intent to turn that king into the function of the Antichrist, the exponential power under the control of those who did not have the capacity to earn it, qualifies the irresponsibility and the nature of the irresponsible in the inability to maintain the function of the structure which was created by those who were competent enough to have created it, and destroyed by those who are incompetent enough to have not made it, but incompetent enough to have wanted to have taken it, and thus qualifying their criminal use of force to cheating in order to win by the disqualifying and the forfeiting under a legal mechanism, ignored by the advantages and spoils of war, qualifying their insurrectionist lust, which is actively backed by their permanent devotion and addiction to evil functions internationally, at which points you have the traumatizing of the general public and the international community into these positions, the racism of the world leaders against David, including the Confederates, which have are engaged in the overthrowing of the United States, have actively infiltrated the mechanism and created dog whistle policies in order to protect the false structure, at which point the racist attack is actively stealing, at which point the function of post-theft is the subversion claim that it is against status, and thus injustice against status is actually injustice against race, because the lack of status is derivative of the criminal use of force for the theft, and the economic terrorist in the subversion qualifies the destruction of the total mechanism, subverting all reason, subverting all law, engaging in the wizard spells in anarchal force, at which point you have the total mechanism of the suicide system, which is only possible, again, with everyone's cooperation, friendly and unfriendly, towards each other, actively agreeing despite their various disagreements, having to consolidate on the greater ambition. They have to forfeit all of their advantages from their original legal contracts in order to consolidate to the insurrectionist position, which is the act of suicide by renouncing the legal structure which they would have prospered under.
The insurrectionists loyal to these coups, such as Durham, Mueller, James Comey, Mattis, as legal characters under the government secret position, which the FBI was obligated to report the definition of the warrants of the illegal surveillance, qualifies their position of attacking David under the position that they had to remove him because they wanted a new system, but they did not want David as a structural system to be a part of their system, at which point the act of racism is qualified from the original position because they don't want me to be a part of their new structure, qualifying the initiation of their exponential compounding of their Nazi loyalties into the genocide. And if there's one thing to understand, it's that those who do not learn from history are doomed to repeat it. And the one thing we know about that is that people will always refuse to learn from history.